I'm a French technical specialist, so I'm based in Grenoble. So in Grenoble office, which used to be the headquarters of Robobat. Robobat, we do the robot files. That's why, as you understand, I'm a structural engineer. And so in Autodesk, I take care of structure and construction. So structure, more Revit, of course. Robot, Navisworks for construction, FieldGlue, this kind of project. And today we are speaking about creating concrete formwork and we are from detailing with Revit. So I don't speak too much about BIM today because there is other session dedicated to this. But of course, the main point is everyone has to do a better design and do better analysis for the BIM to save time and money, okay? With what I show you after, what is the main goal? It's we can do structural analysis, okay, for our side, and we can do some calculations that we used to do very later in the process, and sometimes we do it because it's classic time of the element. We are not allowed to do this kind of calculation, but the main problem is since in the classic element we do this calculator late, it can create problems we have not seen about deflection or size of the reinforcement we need to put in place, something like that. So we will see how to create the structural model, how to create formwork plan, the analytical element in Revit, reinforcement shop drawing, so we come from robot or directly in Revit, and the customer example, a French customer example, who work for classic building and civil construction. So to create the model, there is different workflows. There is a copy monitor link between Revit files. Okay, so you can copy monitor what the, we can say the central file has created. The central file is of course the architecture because the architect has all the idea of the client. So my side, structure side, and MEP side, you will be linked with copy monitor to this file. Okay. And what you can be plus or different, you can link to IFC. Okay. Of course, if you have a Revit native, it's better to link with Revit native because you will have this copy monitor during the time. The difference is during the time, you will be aware of what has been changed, but I will show you just after. And, but I say and it's because sometimes even if you have Revit file, it's important to link the WG file, okay, to be. Because now in some process, it's the WG with mandatory. So the best, if you ask me, but is it better to do this or this? The best is to do both, okay? Because some elements will not be seen in the AIFC, but will be seen in the WG and the opposite, okay? As you may know, when you do copy monitor, we will have slab, column, wall, level, and grid. But if you want to have an overview of everything that has been changed between two versions of the architecture file, there is a tool, a Revit extension tool done by Autodesk. So there is a lot of tools in this tool, but there is a compare model. The compare model will compare exactly the two Revit files and give you all categories difference, which is new, which is different, which has been created, deleted. Okay, so all this help. Of course, we are OpenBIM, and so Revit is certified IFC 2.3, and Revit architecture, Revit MEP or structure. Okay, as you understand. So, how does it proceed to do a copy monitor? What I like in copy monitor is that you start with your own template. Okay, so you start with the structure template, okay, your own template. And after, you will link the architectural file. And what is it nice, because in your own template, you have all the family, you will have a tune to do your job, okay? So you don't need levels, that's why I added them, because you will pick a level of the architect. You just need one, okay? So after I link my Revit file, oh, you will tell me, but why don't you open? I don't open because if, for example, 2 weeks after he sent me another file, I will have to look at the difference. With the copy monitor, the difference will have a report and you will accept or not. Okay? So this is our office in Grenoble. So that's why I have this file. Okay? And you select the link. Okay? And in the option, you see level, grid, column, wall, floor. Okay? That's why you will copy monitor. And so each time, you will copy monitor at first to the same, okay? So original type, okay? If you already work with the architect and you know that, okay, this column is not structural or this column from this size becomes this size, you can change from start. But usually, at start, we copy the original type, you see, for every family, okay? And look at the option below. You can split by level the wall and the column. Okay, because sometimes architects, when they draw, they do a wall from top to from bottom to top, but we prefer to have each level to create. And what is important, it's the AO, which is the reference of the wall. Okay, because structural walls, for example, it's 20 in reinforced concrete. Okay, but the architect have done with insulate, with finish. Okay, and so after we will change this wall to only structural wall, and what we don't want the wall to move. Okay, that's why it's important to choose what will not move. Okay. And once you do this element, you will copy. So at first level, okay, like this, and after you will do grid. It's important to do it this way because after element, we will link to the level and the grid, okay? So now I will do my grid. If you want, sometimes, if you look at my video on my YouTube channel, sometimes I change the name here, put S for structure and plus, but usually in real time, you will pick the same name as the architect, okay? So that's why I don't change it. And once I do this, I copy monitor all my elements. You see, here I have, we don't see the number of elements I copy, and I just click on finish. Okay. And here, after I finish. And if I look at my elements, I will click on finish there, and after finish, to finish. We like to finish. Okay, it copy monitor, and after you have the little symbol who says that it comes from the architecture file, which is copy monitor. Okay, so it creates some time, but during my video, I don't want to split any time. Okay, just for you to have an idea of what time it takes. Okay, and so you can reproduce when you will download my presentation or my video. So here you will see each element which is copy monitored. And once you will have your own file. Okay. So what is good is if 2 weeks after the architect sends you another file, you will replace it and you will have a message. Because now, with this little symbol, the two ID, the ID in the Revit structure element and the ID in the Revit architecture are linked, okay, with this element. For example, I know this big slab, and here, if I unload, okay, so I have no more. This is the file that I've created. Okay. So I don't want this, so I stop the copy monitor, and after I delete. Okay. I delete in my own file. And you have only the structural element of the architecture file. And if the architect moves, you will see after, you will have the link between the two elements. And if the architecture file, we will reload it and it will update. And of course, what I do now, I will show that there is Insulate, okay? And see that I copy every wall, I copy element which is not wall, of course, okay? But after you can see, sometimes, you know, because when you're a structural engineer, you need to understand where it's not a problem to create wall. That's why here I copy monitor every element, because for real, when the architect designed, maybe it's not working as I wish. But I know where I can change this element in real concrete wall. Okay? And so I have an element. So after, if I don't want to see them, since it's not structural, it's not checked. So if I change here, I go to structural, I don't display them. Okay? So up to you, but this is the best workflow, I think. Because sometimes, if you need more rigidity, more wall, you know where to put wall because there is existing element. Okay. Once I've done this, I will select my element. You see, here there is a wall. And I can do my plan. Okay, of course. First floor, second floor. And I cut in the middle and I look up. That's what we do generally with concrete, to know where to put formwork. And here, of course, there is a composite wall. And here I will select, but as I select, you know, in copy monitor, what is my reference, okay, this line won't move. And so after I can select all my reference and change it, okay? Well, in real, I prefer to look, okay? Because if the architect, you know, when he draw the interior or the exterior, he miss, they could have some elements. So in real, if I was the engineer, I would look every level to see if the part we will not move is the correct way. And after, you have only a structural element. Here, of course, it's mainly concrete, but it can be easier if it's steel.
Okay.
So this is the element of copy monitor. Once you've done this, you can, okay, I change element, but what I want after is to, so when you change some element, they can have some angle will change a little bit, and that's why you have the message. And if I'm a good engineer, I read the mission and I look what is in Revit, and if it's correct, up to me, because I'm responsible for what will be what I do. So here, when I copy monitor a little too fast, so I copy monitor even MEP element, which is in my file, which as a structural engineer, it's not my problem, but it gives an idea of the way. If I don't know if there is MEP presentation, but there is the same philosophy with MEP and architect. Once I've done this, you know, if I go to structural, I look at the element, and I can save, okay, to structural, and of course, I will send this file to the architect, okay? Because the link is in the two directions. And the architect, he don't have to do a lot, but he just have to say, okay, this file here is created from mine. So I link the file, okay, so which is the structural one, okay, and here, since my file has been created from this file, I only go to collaborate and say this is the file who has been created with mine. Okay. Copy monitor, select the link, I select and just click finish, okay, and now there is a link between the elements. So if a level change, a wall change, a grid, you will be notified. So I want to do this element, which it's interesting because, you know, when we speak about BIM, BIM is to find the best solution. But when you find the best solution, it means that you improve. You start from something, from the idea of the the need of the customer, the idea of the architect, and moreover, you move. So, project change all the time. Okay. And when you do that, if I reload, so the file has been modified, you are notified like this, okay, and you just have to go to manage here. So you have both ID of Revit and Revit Architect, okay, and if you go to collaborate, you can go to select the link, and here you have the list of what has been modified, okay. And once you've done that, you can postpone. When you click, you see where are the difference, and you can modify, of course. Okay? And usually, you will modify. Okay? And if the architect do the same, it will be notified the same. Okay? So that's why it's better than opening the file. Okay? Because after you opening, you will create. Moreover, you won't have your own template. And here you will have, during the time, what has changed. Okay? So after, to create a workflow, I won't detail too much, but you will create all the, what is needed for the bricklayer to redo the element. So you will create length, size of the openings, distance, all these elements. So, what is fine is when you select, you have anterior wall or pick elements. Okay, if you have anterior wall, create one in one. And sometimes people don't look at the option here, so you have really to take care because this first, 10 years ago, I don't look and I create each one, and after the friend told me that. Okay. And so it's quite the same as AutoCAD, and everyone loves AutoCAD. So, okay. What is different when you are talking to BIM? It's, for example, you bought something, okay? And after you have distance, and I want to change this distance. And of course, I change the distance, but if it moves the selected element, okay? For example, if this distance is not correct, I select what has to move. Okay, for example, the wall, and the wall will move. So, what is important, sometimes, depending on what kind of building you do, is to know where you will put the opening and the size. And here, it's not no more text, it's parameter will come, because it's family. Okay, and with this, you can open the family and change and put all reference you need, and you can, in the Windows family, create more parameters, and in the family you put there, okay, here it's column 2020, you can set as you used to set your AutoCAD file, okay. For the level, you can choose the main part of the slab, but if the slab has some slope, when you pick, you have the real size or the value according to local reference. Okay, so here it's classic. I will move. Okay, to already created plan. So. Of course, you will. What is hard and what asks the more time is you will have the same as you used to do. Okay, and if you are a customer, what you have to do is to find a good reseller to help you, to train you, but more than that, to help you to do all these elements. Because it will be in discussion, you will say, I want that. In fact, this is easy, you have to have that. And this part is more complicated. Is it really important? Okay. And so we can't go to BIM without help. Okay. So if you are a customer and you want to go to BIM, you have to go to see our reseller for you to help. Or Autodesk Consulting if you are close to Autodesk Consulting. what you will have in plus on, in Revit structure when you draw. When you draw, you have a column, you have a beam, you have a wall, you have a slab. But you have the center element. It means that when you send to robot the element, in fact, you don't send the real wall or the real slab, you will send the center line. Okay? And this center line can be auto-adjusted according to, of course, the formwork, but other parts of the element. What is needed when you want, after, to do the calculation according to Eurocode, US code, is you don't want to have two thin finite elements, okay? You want to have an average of elements. So you don't want to have 2 or 3 centimeters, okay? Usually, I will do this little example. In bottom, we have wall about 20, okay? But after, we have smaller wall, around 50 or something like that. But when you send to calculation, you want the center line to be a line, okay? But in real, it's not a line because it's a finish we are aligned, okay? And you will see directly and automatically in Revit, the two elements are aligned. So if you look, of course, I'm fond of robot because it's our software, but this element will be true if you go to SAP, to RAM, all the elements. You will send this element, okay? All the elements, we have a plugin, okay? And for example, some say, yeah, but I prefer to do EIFC. The main problem is this part is not described in EIFC, okay? That's why it's better to have plugin directly to Revit. And after, of course, you can manage. Yeah. You can mean I want in the middle, on the side, on the other side, depending on what you need, okay? So in fact, when you create your structural file, you create two files. You create the file to do the calculation and the file to do the formwork. And after you see, you can say, okay, I want it to be on a grid, okay? Or on a reference plan. And same, for example, you have wall, and to have a good looking, the wall don't finish straight, it finish a little bit closer, okay? For about 5 centimeters or like that. And you don't want this to take into account into your FEM analysis. And you just click to modify, AA, and it will modify. Moreover, when you have a beam like this, who go to the angle, but not really to the angle. You want it to go to the angle. Same, you can correct. You put the unequal element, and you put really where you want. And here, you want a little finite element. Same element, you want the beam really to be in the center line. So you can activate in the column the rigid link. It means that in robot or RAM or SAP, there will be a rigid link you see here. Okay? If you're too much, the rigid link get off, but you can create it manually. Okay? And so this will work in the structural analysis tool. When you create a slab, so classic slab formwork, okay, but you just have to take care to be in automatic adjustment of the line. I will show you just after. If I pick a line, you see here, analytical automatic adjustment. And you see, this is a formwork, and this is a calculation line. Because the calculation line, of course, go in the center of the wall. If you have openings, sometimes, of course, you have big openings. So in calculation, you need them. But sometimes you are small and you don't want them. So what you can do is same, AA to modify the analytical element. You modify, okay, and you can close the opening. Not close the formwork, but the analytical part. Okay, if you look here, there is still the opening. Okay. That's the introduction of how we can say the dream to go from formwork to structural analysis is possible. If all of this don't exist, it won't be possible to do this. Because it will work if I do a simple building, but when you will do your real building, if there is not this, it's impossible to do the calculation. Okay? So as you see during my manipulation, when you have a wall, you have the wall, and if you check a structural element, in plus you have analytic wall. And with this element, you can manipulate only the analytical part of the wall. When you have material, for example, I have a concrete, okay, casting plaques. Here you have the graphic we will need for plan, apparently for my architect colleague for rendering, and there is physical who will go to structural analysis. So, to be precise, for structural analysis, it's the same database of robots. So, in robot, it will be exactly the same. Some other software, like Sophistic, or will match only on the some characteristic and create the other one. For example, they will take this one and they will match with their own materials. Okay. And for SAP or RAM, I mean. So after you come here if you want to change, and you see there is the locked property because all these materials are defined by the rules. Okay, here it's Eurocode. And here you click here, you will reply the element, and you can't change this material. For example, if you need a new concrete with different properties, okay, less rigidity due to local regulation, for example, or because you know in seismic analysis it will be cracks, little cracks, so you have to copy here, and after change the property, and change the name, okay? So if you have to copy and change the name, after when you go to robot, these materials will be created automatically, okay? But you have to change the name because, of course, this material already exists in robot, and if you don't change the name, depending on which robot you use, it will take the robot one, material default, or it will take what is in Revit, okay? So here, what is interesting for me is to split the work between the engineer and the drafter, okay? Because all the work has to be done, and in the past, the engineer do his own structural analysis, drawing, modeling in robot or SAP or RAM, and the drafter do his design in Revit or AutoCAD. Okay, and how it is? It's not so easy to split. Okay, what? Because we want the analytical file. Okay, when we come to robot RAM, just to click to mesh and to be nice. Okay, but all this knowledge, which is a nice structural element, the drafter don't know it because it's not his job. So one good element is with the option here. Is to tell the drafter that, okay, you will put all the analytical elements on the grid, okay? So even if the wall moves a little bit or something changes, everything is on the grid. And visually, if something is not on the grid, you will understand that there is a problem, okay? And maybe, okay, it will be a discussion with the architect and the drafter, and the solution will be solved in the FEM analysis. But you know how to identify where there could be a problem. Okay, so another thing, if you have a very strange building, okay, where the columns are not facing and not facing with the beam 2, it's a good mean to put everything and to be calculated. So in real, our column in robot is not like this, but it could be in another building just for you to understand. Same for beam. For beam, you have here all the properties here to the start and the end for these two nodes here to say where it is. So by default, automatic, it will move as needed. But if you want to be on certain element, you can. Okay. So I will show you here. So you see the beam is there, and by properties, I will say I want to be on this one, okay? And you will see my, or we can say real beam don't move, but my analytical beam move, okay? And I do this for begin and end. Same for column, okay, here. I select and I move the element on this one and this one. Okay? So you see this element to describe to a drafter or a BIM designer on Revit, it's not so hard, okay? And when you go to Robo or SAP, it will be easy because it's all about properties. So even if the size of the column change, we move a little bit like this, all the analytical element will be fine. You see, here there is nothing more. Everything is here. Okay, and so we can now set up a calculation. Of course, I can activate by default rigid link if I want it to stay. So by default, it will do this. Okay, if I activate rigid link, you see, the column stay where it is. So BIM2 and here, the connection is with rigid link. And after you can choose if the rigid link is from the column or from the BIM, okay? And so when you activate by default, it creates both, but after, if you select one, you can say, no, I want this in rigid link. You can do the same graphically in 3D or in 2D, but here it's more demonstrative. So if you go to modify AA, okay, after there is grip, okay, so click AA to have this, because if you don't have this, you will move the real column, and here you can move, but you will never do this, because if you do this, your column will be like that, okay, and you have a bending moment, and it will, no, but it can, sometimes it can help. So, if after I can take the other one to put it straight again. That's why there is another grip you can put in the middle. Okay? So, AA again, just for you to see. Here. And here, I select, and instead of the node, I will pick the local element. And here, you will notice that it stays straight, and you have, like you know in Revit, the auto alignment. Okay, so I will do one side, other side, just for you to know what to do. Okay, and after you see here, it's written manually adjusting. Okay, so with all these tools, okay, you will create a good analytical element, so you can do the calculation. Oh, easy, you can do it graphically, okay? With, because in fact we want them to be aligned, so we just have to select a line, and we align the element, and after you can lock if you need, and same, it will be manually adjusted. So if you think about all this, with all this, you can do a real good job. So you will see you have rafter. So same with rafter, after you have local adjustment, and you can do it. So you have already seen. Here you have analytical elements in the continuous footing and isolated footing. But if I were you, I won't use this because it's not auto-adjusted according to the wall. So I will create what just after. So I don't create anything, and I will create in the FEM analysis. Or I create support, okay? Support on line, okay, on point, or surface. After you have load case, so usually I create only live load and dead load in load case, because my FEM analysis will create the other one and create the element in. And you can put loads in it. What is interesting is there is hosted area, you see, hosted. It means that if, for example, your slab move or your beam move or the top of the column move, no, yeah. The loads will move automatically. Okay? And if you have a local load, okay, you can define it, but it's not hosted, of course. And you can define different properties and value for this load. After, if needed, you can create a combination, load combination. Honestly, usually there is 100 of combinations. So what I create in my own template is 4-5 classic main combinations that everyone like. Okay? And of course, you have them back in robots. So yeah, it's how we set. So at the end, before sending the element to robot Sam, I want you to look at the file like this, okay? And to see if you have only one line, and if you don't see a lot of lines like this. Yeah, because if you see a lot of lines like this, when you go to the FEM analysis, it won't be fine. And after you send to robot, and here, you see I don't have to correct a lot, I can mesh directly, okay? And if you're not fond of Revit because you don't see, what you will do at first is you do one level, you send to FEM analysis, and you see if the mesh is correct, okay? And after you do the first floor plus second floor, okay? And I'm sure in 10 years everyone will do this. But you have to think, now we work from one way, we want to go to another way, okay? And it's a transition. You have to understand what will be done by the architect, what will be done by the drafter. And after you can do systemic analysis. Sorry, here it's in French, but it's Eurocode 8 analysis. Okay, but you can do the same with American or Spectral or what you need. And when you do that, you can be sure of, okay, do I have enough mode, okay, or something like that. But after, you can look at what you have taken into account in your analysis, and you can justify your steel and the concrete. Here you have steel, concrete, and wood. Okay, so here you will do the calculation. This column is in steel. Okay, so I have here, for example, it's the same process for American codes, but here it's Eurocode. And here I will do the assembly at the bottom. Okay, and I can do, of course, element in steel, and I will do the calculation according to Eurocode. Okay, and once you've done your steel, you want to do the calculation of your slab, okay? Same, you will have the needed reinforcement of the slab, like this, okay? And you can do your column, you can do your beam, etc. So, I think you manage not to know where I want to go. So there is different ways to go. Because from Revit, you can go to robot, okay, to robot shell, as you see, okay? And then to robot shell, you can go to robot real beam element, which creates real 3D reinforcement of the beam. You can go to Revit directly to robot real beam. But of course, here you will have to put your own loads. But, you know, if you have only a slab from one side and a slab from the other side, you don't need finite element for that. Okay? And if it's more complicated, if it's civil construction, from robot, you won't ask real reinforcement, you will ask theoretical reinforcement. Okay? And of course, if it's really complex, you will do a direct shape reinforcement in Revit. And for slab, usually you will put wire fabric or steel to it. Okay, so different workflow. Okay, so all FEM, FEM to detail element, and detail element back to Revit. Okay, with 3D. Other elements, you know, easy the load, but you want a precise calculation of the deflection, for example. And here you can send only the beam to robot, in robot beam, or robot column, or robot slab, or robot wall. And you can send back the 3D reinforcement. Okay? So just a small video for you to understand. So I send, okay, and after I can see if it's correct. Once I do this, I will do the calculation and I will send. So here I have an application, and here I will select what I want, for example, two or three columns, and I go to reinforcement. Okay, so you select the support, simple case, and here you have your bill, and you just have to do the calculation according to the local regulation you need. Okay, and here you have the 3D reinforcement. You can do opening, you can do what you want. You have the calculation note according to your local regulation, can be your code, US rule, China, India. And you have in PDF, sometimes customer just print this PDF, and you can come back to Revit. Okay? And here you have the 3D reinforcement who come back. Okay? And of course, after, you can, if you want, do your detail in Revit. Okay? So I can set a view. And after, so there is here, but you will use this one. Okay. So of course you will manage all these elements as you wish to see elements. Okay, to find the same as you already done for your construction company or your office. Okay, same for the cut. Okay, you will put the reinforcement. So, and of course here it has been created, but you can create it manually, but since it's automatically done in robot, I prefer to use it. Okay, and after you can do some color with size or with number like I've done. Okay, this is classic filter you already know. And after you have the bomb, okay, with the shape and the length and the element, and you can put in 3D in plus for the customer to better understand what he will do. Okay, so same process, but here you will get back only theoretical reinforcement. It means the size, okay, not all the detail, and you can come back to Revit too. Okay. Okay, and I won't show you because I'm late of time, but it's globally the same. Okay. And after you can launch some extension if you want them to check and to verify. If you have to do this kind of reinforcement, here you will do more free reinforcement. It means that you will select, okay, where you want to put the reinforcement. Okay, so here I select the wall, okay, and after I draw the reinforcement, but before I select the size, and it automatically creates the good shape. Okay, I select what I want, I select, you know, the number I want, or if I want a space, and after, since I select, no, it was not a wall, it was a column, okay, you know how to put. Okay. And after, I can do some filter according to size or number. Okay. So there is two ways. Here I've done three reinforcement, and you can create by shape code. You see, here there is shape code, and when you put in the formwork, it will adjust according to the cover. Okay. And of course you can change cover of every element. Here I want to have this space, okay, and after I can adjust when to start and when to finish. And I want to have my start, okay, to engineer the wall upper. So I will draw it. So there, I think there was some soil from one side, that's why I've done it. I choose the number or the space. You can choose the number or the space if you want. And after, I want to be this, put this one on top of this one, or near this one, okay? And so this is the two big ways for reinforcement. Last element we have is wire fabric. So I will select where I want my wire fabric, okay? I will adjust like you know for slab and all elements. I will select in which way I put my wire fabric, which wire fabric I want, okay? And after it's finished, I have my wire fabric, okay? And okay, same for slab, okay? You will have theoretical reinforcement and you will put reinforced fabric on it, okay? And you can have result back in Revit. And well, honestly, to do a slab, it can be automatic. So the drafter will have to select, with the help of the engineer, the good way to do this, okay? So classically, we send the element, okay? We mesh, do the calculation of the slab, and after, we come back to Revit. Oh, what is important is you can send multiple robot files. It means here I send all the files, but if I wonder only on the slab, I can send only the slab. And I can mix results only on the slab with the global analysis in Revit because result package can be different. Okay? So here I have my result. Okay. And of course, you can mix support because sometimes you don't want the beam. You want the beam to be rigid, okay? When you calculate the slab, which is not true when you calculate the wall building. So you can change to put more support, or you can change to be pinned or not. And once you've done that, you can update. Okay, here. And here, you will update the section top-bottom in X or Y, okay, classically. And after, you will choose the same. I will choose, this is the bottom needed reinforcement. I'll choose, so here, I choose easily to create for every slab one wire fabric, okay. But in a way, okay, you see it changed the way, and when you finish, it cuts the wire fabric. So at the end, you have the reinforcement you will buy, and the reinforcement will be in the building. Okay, and the difference should be not too much if you are a good structural engineer. Okay. And after you can put classic drawing of how you represent the element, and of course you can create the name if needed. Okay. Of course, this is parametric, but you know, you will do the same for top reinforcement. After you will have your wire fabric bomb. Okay. And so you will ask for a calculation. And of course, classic thing of it, you will just have to put on your final drawing what you want with all the elements. And if you want, you can put in plus the needed reinforcement if you have a controller who likes that. Okay. So you can do a lot of elements. What is nice too, sometimes when reinforcement is quite complicated, you can use this functionality, okay, to split and to explain how it will be built. Okay? This is classic Revit functionality, which is useful for, of course, all elements, but I think mainly for reinforcement, from my side as structural engineer. And if you want to do reinforcement of this kind of element, you have to use API or Dynamo, okay? Which is brand new for 1 month in Dynamo, I think. Okay? So I have some time left. So I will show you some customer example in France. The main fact is when they want to move to BIM, it was a will of their direction. Okay. That to move to BIM, the easy part is to buy Revit or another software. But I prefer you to buy Revit. Okay. But this is easy part. After you have to train, okay, and to create your own template. And you have to learn how to work with the other part of the building, which is where you will have all the value of BIM. Okay? Because if you do BIM by your own in your structural office, you will have less value for the final consumer or construction company than if every if all the ecosystem moves to BIM. So, you know, here you will look, it's look like what they used to do, because it's what their customer used to have on the field, so they want to have the same thing. But I would say, hopefully, it's better. If you don't have anything better, you don't change. Okay? Because you have all the 3D we have, and all the cut, which is no cut, theoretical cut, but cut from the real file. Okay. And if, for example, there is something, sorry, the resolution is very small. If there is something who is not so accurate, you can come and you will have all the detail and the quantity of reinforcement of the quantity or element. For example, if I want to go to this, I will go to plan view, this level, okay? And here, if you look, I have all the other element link. So here, if I don't crop, okay, you will have all the other building. Which, you know, when you have to create new buildings, there is always existing one, it could have point cloud, and when you have to choose a BIM software, it has to be open and very strong, because when you, for example, if I do a cut, okay, what you don't want, and I don't want you, is to wait. And here, if I create a view, it's instantaneous. Of course, it's not because I can create a view that it's a useful view. Okay? You still have to be a good drafter to create useful view. But you see, and you can manipulate it easily, even with this side. And if you go to the 3D view, you can see the section I've done. So it will be the last one, I think. So, yeah, of course, now, since cuts are easy to do, we do more cuts, okay? But they like it on the field because everyone likes cuts. The only part of cuts is that sometimes it's time-consuming when you create it, and it's time-consuming for them to be accurate all around the element. And you can be sure that if one is not accurate, on the field they will look this one at the wrong time. So here you see, and you have all the detail, and of course, you can move, and this is the real strong of Revit, that everything is dynamic, and no matter the size, of course, you have to have a computer professional, but you can work, there is no waiting time. Okay, this customer do another things, and after, I think, it will finish in 5 minutes now. Yeah, you are the timekeeper. I have another for you. No, it was in seven minutes. Okay. So the other element he has done is more for water treatment station. And you see this office who have done that, they are two structural engineers and seven drafters. We don't speak about main European French company like Bouygues Orvincé. It's a small office, but he understands that if he moves the first to the BIM, it will be the BIM winner. It means that nowadays in France, a lot of main constructors want to have BIM, and they know this office can do it because they do it for about 2 years. Okay, because what I don't show you, it's of course this has already been built and not built 2 months ago. Okay, it has been built 2 years ago. Okay, and it's the same I think for the other one. And I want just to say something that I finish on plan, because nowadays what they need on the field is plan. Okay, and what is strong with Revit is that the plan is really connected to the 3D. Okay, and when you move the 3D, it's changed here, and you can do the same as you used to do. Okay, of course you can do it a little bit differently because you have more possibility. Okay, for example, okay, this one, I'm sure if you're all structural office, you will do quite the same. Okay, but with the possibility, it was maybe, yeah, this is reinforcement, adaptive reinforcement. I think this is a 3D cut. Okay, so you will do this quite the same, or maybe without color. Okay, but you can do the same. Here you can do the same with AutoCAD. Okay, everyone is fond of AutoCAD. Me too, but I don't tell it too much. But you see, when there is deflection a little bit everywhere, and it's easy, and there is three times the same, but not really the same, it's easy to do a mistake. Okay, and so here you see they put all level in 3D, and of course this is all dynamic. Okay, this is parametric. If I come, sorry for the small screen. If I come here, you see, this is a real family. Okay, it's not only text. Okay, so I will take some questions now. If you want to see something, or yeah. Land? More than 12? Slice, like this? To split automatically?
Yeah.
It's not, I think there may be some extension, but I don't know. Yeah, but we work, you know, now Autodesk, we work mainly on Revit, but we know there is some feature. You have to split by your own and put the connection by your own. Yeah. Yeah, but, you know, I love AutoCAD, but when you move to Revit, we don't want to create all functionality. It means that all functionality we create, they're full BIM integrated. And so it's really time consuming to create all functionalities that we have now in advanced concrete. Oui? Yes? Yeah, I have to test. But do you have, because it's in place, the column? It's a real column. Okay. And maybe if you test, yeah. Yes. Yeah, in place. Yeah. Yeah, but you can select. Okay, I want to create. Yeah, but at the end, when you select,
You can, if you... Aye, but it's, there is a message. When you, because when you select, I will create a new. And there is a message that you don't support. But the best is to ask our support. Autodesk support. You go, there is some forums. You go with your account. And after you create, and my colleague from development will answer. But and or you can ask your reseller, and your reseller can create it for you. Support is there is one support in EMEA, one support in America. Yes, yeah. There is some colleague of me in Munich office who do support on this. And if it don't work, it go to the dev team, which is in Boston, near Boston. But if you have no answer, you have to ask your local reseller, okay? And with your local account, if you have paid, you have right to support. Of course, if you have not paid, no support. Other question, yeah? Yes, sorry, there is a lot of video in French, because as you understand, in French. But I have done some video in English. Yeah, no, because there is no internet. So, old school. My channel is Village BIM S. Bama. And you will see there is all this video, because this video, there is a show in France called Batinat, and I do the same. So the audio will be in French, but if you have all the display, I think you will try to do the same manipulation. But I think it's recorded. So like Autodesk University in Vegas, I think it will be available online, but I don't know when and where. Okay, so I don't know if it's like Autodesk University, you have to say if it was correct or not. But so if it was correct, you say, and if you think it's not correct, you don't say. No, it's a joke. Yeah?
I got one question. What do you think about Sophistic?
Yeah, Sophistic is a good software, and it's linked from the same one as Robot. Sophistic won't do the real reinforcement in 3D. In their own FEM, come back to Robot, you will have those I don't show, the theoretical reinforcement. And you can put the same the reinforcement in the Revit.
You do have some problems if you go use Sophistic as a demo and then come back and you've got calculated the template and certain other families with other parameters, and then it keeps asking to validate those parameters.
Yeah, because I want to do a benchmark, in fact, just to see that we have the same result between two FEM analysis, but our customer likes that we have the same result because it says it's true. And when I come back, I have message of result package. But I speak about Sophistic, and I think they will solve this element.
Another one I've got is export from Revit to STAT.
STAT, yeah.
Is that a direct one, not like SAFE? Because at the moment, in my practice, they're busy using SAFE, but
yeah.
To take anything out into AutoCAD, then take it to SAFE, modify it in SAFE before you can use it, then do your calculations, do as many iterations as are required, but you take it back to Revit, it's now a dumb AutoCAD file. So you lose the workflow.
I know many robots. So the correction of the analytical element I show will be valid with all other software, if they've done their job correctly. But you know, SAP, Sophistic, even LaTeX, they are. I don't say there is no bug, but it will work. Maybe it's not working now for package result or something, but I think it will work. But of course, for our team, it's easy because Revit and Robot share the same database. And so, for example, if you create a file directly in Robot, you can create a blank file in Revit, and it will create all families. You know, I think the other software, I've not the same level of integration as we have with our software. But the idea, of course, we like to sell our software, but it's to have in-house software to know every problem that customer can be part, okay? And if we can solve with our software, I'm sure Sophistic, SAP, RAM can solve too. You know?
We get a lot of negative things. We're presently implementing a conversion now.
Yeah.
In Saudi Arabia, all accounts are asking for their finite analysis in SAP.
Yeah.
In SAP, the reports have to come out in Life Mechanical, they have to come out in HFP, even though we don't want to use that.
Yeah. After, you know, things change. So, for example, 3 years ago, I've done the same kind of presentation, but there was very few functionality to move the analytical elements. And I could say that, for example, 3 years ago, it would be hard to do the same because there was not a lot of properties. But what is good now with properties, it's if you log to axes of reference plan, you're sure that if you go to robots and plan, it will be nice. Because usually when you move with the hand, it was not so precise. You know. Okay. So I think it won't work on it, so it will be available online. Yeah?
Question.
Okay. Thank you.